What's going on, guys? Mr. Miata Nut here. We're back at Mr. Miata Nut World Headquarters. It's the next day. You know, yesterday we got the transmission back in the 911. We got the new clutch slave cylinder installed, the new clutch, pressure plate, all that good stuff on the flywheel and everything installed back in there. It really fought us yesterday and it about did me in last night. But we're back at it again here the next day. And we're gonna go ahead and finish buttoning up everything on the transmission, the rear transmission mount, the coolant lines, shifter cables, the axles. We're gonna get all that good stuff back bolted up in place. And let's get going on it. We're gonna start by getting this rear transmission mount back in place. Let me grab that real quick. Let's see what we need here. Tell you what, maybe we'll go and get this, get the coolant line hooked back up, which is real easy. Get this clip down here. Clip in place and then there we go. Got that line in place. Next thing we want to look at getting this bracket in here. We need to go ahead and go on up with the transmission a little bit. Get these nuts on this bracket here. Got a couple bolts that go through the right through the mount on the back of the transmission. Let's see. Going up a little more. I think we're good. Get the transmission jack out of the way. I think everything looks good and we'll snug everything up now. Actually, before we get too far, let me get this these shifter cables out of the way. Actually, I'm gonna go ahead and just stick those on there. So here's one. Awesome. All right, we got our shifter cables in place. And let's go back and let's get the mounts snugged up. All right, got the transmission mount all snugged up and tight. Next, we got a couple of coolant lines here for the heater hoses, and we got the main battery cable here all bolted to the side of the transmission. Start with this battery cable up top. Actually, looks like we need to get the coolant lines attached before we get the electrical line up there. That's a short one. There's a short one. Actually, there's the bracket right here. Awesome. All right, get the axle back in place there. Now let's finish up this battery cable right here. I got the two right up here at the top. Alright, got those snugged up. Now we got two more bolts on the bottom of the transmission. Actually, I already had and snugged up all the top bolts and also hooked up the reverse switch on the top of the transmission here just a little while ago. But let's get these two in the bottom here. Again, we're using the triple square. There we go. Bottom bolt here and get it snugged up. Let's see if I got a find my ratcheting wrench. There we go. Got a nice ratcheting wrench here. It makes it so much easier. All right, got one little snug there. All right, got that one tight. And we got one more bolt right here. It's got a bolt with the nut on it. I think that's the 15 again. Yeah. Put our wrench on the back side and ratchet on the front. All right. Now we've got all the transmission bolts snugged up. We've got the coolant lines all in place, the battery cable in place. Now let's go ahead and let's get these cross members in here. Actually, I'll tell you what, before we do that, let's go ahead and get these axles in place. Actually, come to think about it, we better put just a little bit of Loctite and back those back out. A little bit of blue Loctite on those bolts. Now let's get those started again. We'll go back at a crisscross pattern. And one more on the top side here. Alright, I think we got that axle in good. Now let's go on to the next axle. Grab our blue Loctite. All right, got our Loctite on there. Let's get these in place. two more right on top. Get them snugged up and we'll go back and tighten everything. Let's go back to the other side. I was working over your head. I'm about to put a crick in my neck. All right, and there we have it. We got the axles all bolted up in place. Got everything nice and tight. Let's go ahead and get the subframe in place, subframe brace. Let's see if we remember which way it goes which. Looks like it may be the... Oh, it is different. I think this is the... block of wood and get this little. Let's get our two bolts on the top started up. Tell you what, I think we're going to need to get this, see if I can get this one started. Push up on these subframes. Oh yeah, that's a lot better. All right, got this side in. Now let's move back over to this side. There we go. Got our subframe in. Let's get the nuts on the back side and get that tightened up. Pull this out of the way. All right, got that snugged up. Let's get these two. Got the transmission in the car, got the subframe in, got all the braces in. Oh, wait, we got two more braces. Three more braces. Let's see what we got here. Trying to remember how these go. Here we go. All right, there we go. We got Two more nuts right on top. Got one snug down. Let's get this one. All right. And there we have it. The transmission's in, all the braces are in. Next we need to do is bleed the clutch. We need to change out the gear oil and the transaxle here, and change the engine oil. And we also got us a new water pump, got us a new thermostat to go in here, and a few pulleys put on the motor. So we're gonna take a break for a minute, and we'll get back to it here in just a second.